I am Anna Seewald, and this is Authentic Parenting, a podcast about personal development in the context of parenting, where I explore how you can find more calm, connection, and joy in parenting through the process of self-discovery and inner growth with a trauma-informed lens. This is a solo episode. In 1988, on December 7th, a severe earthquake happened in my hometown, and I lost everything. As I always say, I lost everything but found myself. I was only 13, and my life was never the same. Today, I live in the United States. I have a good life. I am married. I have a private practice. I have this amazing podcast and the growing global, international, awesome community of people and supporters. And I am very happy. I'm very content. Today, I want to share with you some of the major life lessons I have learned as a result of that experience. Here we go. A few years ago, I was invited to be a guest on someone's podcast about resilience. The host had asked me to write down some lessons that I learned through my life experience of surviving the earthquake in 1988. That was a really great exercise because I had never thought about my life in that way. I had never reflected back and said, these are the 10 lessons that I have learned. And when I sat down, it all came together. You know, when we go through life, through difficult periods, through trauma, adversity, of course, it's hard. And in that moment, we don't pause and say, what are the lessons that I'm learning right now? Many, many years later, only we can look back at our life and try to make sense and even summarize into lessons that we have learned. So here we go. I was a little girl, a 13-year-old, very innocent young girl, when the earthquake happened in 1988 on December 7th. My life turned upside down. It was never the same. I don't want to share, you know, the tragedy and the hardship that I went through. If you would like to listen to the full story, I was interviewed about that experience on the Grief Dreams podcast, and it's a really good in-depth interview. I released that interview on my own podcast since I wanted to share with my listeners my own story. It's a pretty sad story, so if you don't want to be depressed, if you don't want to cry, you can skip that episode. But if you want to know who I am, where I come from, and what's my story, so you can definitely check out that episode. It's called Overcoming Childhood Adversity. So here we go. I enumerated those life lessons somehow, but of course they are in no particular order. I have not looked at this list for a couple of years. So the first lesson I have learned is every day is a gift. Truly, when you experience something like an earthquake, a natural disaster, when your world collapses and disappears in literally seconds, and you find yourself alive, every day becomes a gift. And today I live my life just like that, trying to enjoy life, celebrate life, and truly view it as a gift. Second lesson I have is possessions don't matter, own less. This is a lesson that I live by every single day. I have a simple lifestyle. I have a simple wardrobe. I own less stuff, less clutter. Truly, when you lose everything in a matter of seconds, possessions lose their value, their meaning. So today, I don't try to buy much and attach myself to things. I don't strive to purchase a big house, a mansion, have a yacht or an airplane. I don't even dream about owning things like that. I try to enjoy people, experiences, and live pretty simply. Deep gratitude, that's the lesson number three that I have on my list. Truly, I have deep gratitude for everything, for life, for people, for nature, for sun, for the moon, for everything in life. You know, we have so much to be grateful for. We take it for granted. Life is unpredictable. Of course, that's a lesson you learn when you experience a natural disaster, right? You can plan, you can organize, you can make decisions, but you know what? Life is truly unpredictable. And so I learned to embrace that concept and go with the flow. Embrace the what is. Accept what is the reality and not fight with it. I learned this from a young age, and I think it has been serving me very well. It's sort of this Buddhist Zen approach, which I never knew before, which I didn't know about as I grew older and I learned about other philosophies, and particularly mindfulness, meditation, Buddhism, a little bit. I learned those lessons early on through experiencing life. There is nothing you can do. You can't fight with reality. You know, you might as well accept what is, because it brings so much peace and calmness instead of fighting with reality, wanting things to be a particular way, trying to gain control, which of course we know is an illusion. You know, we can't control people, we can't control things, we can't control circumstances. And so I learned this lesson very early on, and it has been truly life-changing. Life is ephemeral. Live to the fullest. That's what I learned. And I truly celebrate life, the small, ordinary, everyday moments. You know, life is so bright and rich and vivid for me when I am having a little spaghetti dinner with my family or when I'm just walking outside. I truly, truly drop into the present moment and enjoy everything. When I'm walking in nature, I look at leaves, at little twigs, at stones, at everything around me. And I have this immense curiosity and joy when I experience life in nature. And I'm very grateful for that. I think this has happened as a result of my experience. I have also learned to speak from the heart, say things to people, the things that they need to hear, words of appreciation, compliments, words of love. You know, why hold it inside? It's hard to be vulnerable and open, but it truly makes a big difference. You connect with people on a much deeper level. So it's been a gift for me to be able to speak from the heart. And I'm not talking about negative things. Of course, sometimes there are judgments, assumptions, or negative things we hold in our heart. But that's not what I'm talking about when I say speak from the heart. If you want to say something to someone, if you want to say to your mother or your sister or your friend or your neighbor or a teacher how they changed your life, how they make your life beautiful, how they enrich your life, don't hold those words of appreciation and love in your heart. Let it go. People need to hear those messages. Those messages don't have to be stuck in your heart. They are yearning for traveling and going to the people who deserve to hear those messages. I also learned that all we have is the now, right? The present moment. And I also learned that we can't undo the past. We can learn things from our past, and our past will always be part of our story. But I don't want to be defined by my past. I don't want people to feel sorry for me. I don't want people to remember me by my past, because the past is gone. I don't want to clench and hold on to the past and be stuck in victimhood. I want to live in the present moment and enjoy life to the fullest. Because again, life is unpredictable. Life is ephemeral. And we need to enjoy every single moment. Another thing I have learned is relationships are gifts. Treat them like such. Nurture them. Esther Perel says, quality of our relationships determines the quality of our life. And I truly believe that to be true. Another lesson I learned is that people come together in tragedy. You know, we share this common humanity. And something tragic happens on a massive scale. Something happens in people. People become more compassionate, more empathic. They want to help one another. I have witnessed that. And it's so amazing to have experienced and witnessed that. And I carry that sense with me. You know, when I see some negative things happening in our life, wars and fights and people hurting one another, I always remember and believe in the goodness of people. Another lesson I learned is pain is universal. It's part of life, right? Suffering is optional, I guess. We all suffer in our own way, but pain is inevitable. Suffering is inevitable. It's part of life. Also, loss and grief are part of life. Trauma is a fact of life. So fighting with things to change and want life to be different is a lost battle. So let's appreciate what we have and make the best of it. Another point I have in my notebook is there might be a reason we are alive. Given this life, I don't take it lightly. I'm not sure what I thought at the moment when I wrote this, but it sounds pretty true to me today too, right? Have you thought about this concept? Like, why are we here on this earth? Is it random? Do we have gifts? Are we meant to be here? Are we meant to meet one another? Are we destined to meet the people in our life that enter into our lives? I truly treasure everybody who somehow gets in touch with me, enters into my life, and I value each and every relationship. I have spoken about this on the podcast before. It kind of sounds naive and romantic in some way and mystical, but I love a little mysticism in life. Another point I have written in my notebook is I have learned to have faith and go with the flow, as I understand that I cannot control life even if I try relentlessly. I think I've spoken about this already. Know that you are always where you're supposed to be. You are being guided. And I have written down a quote here by Eckhart Tolle. Surrender is the simple but profound wisdom of yielding rather than opposing the flow of life. Beautiful, isn't it? I have also learned introspection, deep introspection, because when the earthquake happened, everybody was left with their own loss, with their own grief, with their own emotions. You know, there was a period of time that I was frozen. I couldn't cry. I couldn't eat. And later, you know, it was so enormous, the pain, that it was hard to process. Everybody was busy with their own loss and processing, perhaps, of their own stuff. So I learned to be by myself, with myself, and look inwards. and try to understand myself and appreciate the gift of introspection, self-awareness. And I think that has served me a lot in my life. Another thing I have learned is being with boredom, being with nothingness, being with the slowness and the slow pace of life. No TV, no lights, nothing. Because after the earthquake, we lost everything. And at that time in Armenia, there was a war, there was an economic blockade. It was a difficult time. There was no electricity, no food, no heat. You know, I have seen a lot of pain and suffering. And what I've learned is human beings are pretty adaptable. We are very adaptable and resilient. We are pretty ingenious and resourceful, you know, in difficult times. And it amazes me that capacity that humans have, that you can make something out of nothing. There were times that the time stood still. There was nothing. We had nothing. And there was boredom. And there was you and your inner world. And so I learned to be okay with that. Today, I can sit down in the morning with a cup of tea and do nothing, absolutely nothing, for 30 minutes, for 1 hour. Just reflect, daydream, meditate. And I enjoy that process. I think that's a gift. I also learned to be vigilant, right? I mean, that's a sign and symptom of trauma to be hypervigilant. But I think I look at it positively. You know, hypervigilance is not a bad thing. I am very cautious and I think it has helped me. So I want to look at it as a gift. I have also learned to be very empathic. I think when someone goes through a difficult hardship, your heart opens up and you understand pain, human suffering on a completely different level, and you relate to people, you become more empathic. I think I'm a very highly sensitive person to begin with. I'm an empath, and having gone through this life experience has opened me up even more. And so that helps me in my work with parents. I connect with people to their pain, to their suffering. Something has shifted in me profoundly after this experience. And I have noticed this capacity in other people who have gone through adversity, trauma, and difficult experiences. I have also learned to read people. This was a survival skill, I guess, after the earthquake, because we were evacuated many times. I lived in foreign countries and I had to be pretty quick to read people. Who is my friend? Who is my foe? As a little girl, right? As a 13-year-old, innocent, inexperienced child, I had to be very quick on my feet. And I am pretty damn good about this today. I read people, I am this human scanner, and I think it's a tremendous gift. When I work with people in my office, sometimes a person can, I'm just remembering a specific case, I sense people. I have this energetic way of sensing people. When somebody is lying, I know they are lying. Or sometimes I can predict things about them, about the future. And it can freak people out sometimes. My cousin was over a few weeks ago and we were having a conversation, just a random conversation about TV shows and programs and things like that from the past, from the present, and all of that. And he said, my favorite show is, and I said his favorite show. And he's like, how did you know what I was going to say? I'm like, I don't know. I just had a sense, you know, and I go with this. I trust this intuition that I have. I think reading people, sensing their energy, being an empath, being, you know, having this tremendous empathy, I fine-tuned it. I love it. I lean into it and I view it as a gift. And I trust in that. It helps me tremendously navigating my life. I also sense the energy in environments. When I visit a friend or someone's house, I can sense there was a fight here an hour ago, let's say. You know, the lingering energy is still there. I am so in tune with that. Of course, this is not always true, but it helps me and I trust in that. And you can say I am naive, but I enjoy tuning into this, what I call a superpower, let's say, right? Another lesson I have learned is I love nature. I am in awe of nature, what it brings, what it offers. And I spent a lot of time every day in nature. I cannot survive without nature. Even though I suffered through a natural disaster, I still think it's magical, mystical, powerful, even the earthquake, right? I mean, what happens in the world? Nature is truly powerful. I think it's God. When I was a teenager, I was in this rebellious phase of my life. And, you know, I would say, oh, I don't believe in God. God took my mom. I don't believe in God and things like that. I believe in nature. And I still believe that there is power in nature. I'm in awe. The way I appreciate nature, I think, is pretty remarkable. You know, I sense nature with every inch of my body, with every cell of my body. I enjoy everything, the rain, the snow, you know, the trees, the birds, the flowers. I truly am in awe and I'm in love with nature. It's very healing for me. Another point I have in my notebook is life's challenges are manageable. Attitude perspective. I don't know what I meant at the time when I wrote this, but thinking about this today, I believe that life's challenges are manageable. It requires a specific mindset. Sometimes we need to reframe things. It requires an attitude, a can-do, a positive attitude, not the victimhood attitude, an appropriate perspective. Because perspective is everything. And I sometimes take photographs of the same scene from different angles, from different perspectives, and I post them on Instagram just to show how things change when we look at them differently. So I always want to have this fresh perspective. As I turn the page in my notebook, I see that I have several notes here to go with the main points, with the main lessons. Here, what I wrote. Another thing was the nature, miles and miles of uncultivated pure nature, valleys, mountains, fields of wild flowers, blue skies. I felt at home. I felt one with nature. It was the only thing that was constant, always changing colors and light, but always being there. Strong. Even though my pain was caused by a natural disaster, I revere nature deeply. I do not fear it. I would go on long walks with no particular end destination and just feel the oneness. And songs and lyrics and music would come to me. I would repeat a million times until I went home and wrote it down. Oh my gosh, this is so true. In Spitak, my hometown, after the earthquake, this is so true. I would go on long walks in nature and all of a sudden I would hear a song in my head and words would come and music. And I truly believe that like I was receiving a gift from above or from somewhere else. As a longtime listener, you may know that, you know, I never took piano lessons. I never took music lessons, but I have a gift. I was embarrassed to admit, but now I admit that I have a gift and it was given to me. It was opened up this gift right after the earthquake when I was experiencing this oneness with nature, as pompous as it sounds. ever since I started composing music and songs and poetry. And so I think that's remarkable, and it's phenomenal that when we become aligned with nature, with the universe, or with God, or with higher power, I think we vibrate differently. We become one with nature. This consciousness is there. I don't know how else to explain this, but there is something there that we can tap into, that source, because we are that source also. But somehow we get stuck in our life, you know, busy life, activities, schedules, and the mundane stuff. And we forget the beauty, the amazing world and the universe that's out there. When we align ourselves with that, we receive the gifts. And I wish that for you as well. These were the lessons that I have learned as a result of the severe earthquake I experienced in 1988, when I was only 13, where I lost my mom, my cousin, my aunt, a lot of my classmates, my neighbors, and everything else. Even my memories, even my photographs. I have very few things from my childhood, from my life. And I have been alive now many more years, right? After the earthquake, it's been 30 years. And somehow it doesn't even feel that that was my life. That was me, that I had that life. And it's just amazing how life changes. So I want to conclude this episode, this somewhat random episode that I meant to do in a couple of years. And I even forgot to mention that when I was invited to that podcast to share those lessons, that never materialized. So I guess this was the right choice. This was the right thing to do, to share it here on my podcast. So I want you to look at your life and perhaps take a moment today or some other day to reflect about the gifts of that particular experience. I know when you experience trauma, abuse, violence, when you're going through hardship, of course, I don't want to minimize that experience, but there are also gifts that come with it. Or maybe you don't want to use the word gifts. Only years later, we can look back and say, this is what I have learned. Maybe say lessons, don't say gifts. But I truly believe that there are gifts in those horrific hardship situations and life experiences that we go through. I want you to have that perspective that there is hope, that there is a possibility that you can heal no matter what you have gone through. I know from my own life experience, you can have a better, more meaningful, joyful life. If you are in a hardship right now, believe that's possible one day. I want to send you a big hug, big love, and thank you for being part of the Authentic Parenting community.